circles and angles.
Hello. Today we're showing typical interfaces from NVE's AAT angle sensors to simple microcontrollers. We have two demos, a simple three-digit interface and a more precise four-digit demo. We use a radial magnet, and there's an AAT angle sensor on this board. The sensor outputs follow the sine and cosine of the magnet angle. There are several AAT sensor versions with different resistances. The AAT-003 has 40 kiloohm elements for a 20 kiloohm output impedance, which is ideal for direct interface to the analog inputs of simple microcontrollers. We're interfacing to an Atmel Mega 328 on an Arduino board. The first example is a three-digit readout for 1 degree resolution. We have an analog output from the micro connected to an inexpensive panel meter through a single-ended scaling voltage divider. The program uses the microcontroller's built-in 16-bit timer counter to produce a pulse-width modulated analog output. This program uses a simple 10-bit PWM library, which is fine for 1 degree resolution. We initialize the PWM timer. The main program is only one line where we read two sensor outputs, calculate the angle using a two-variable arctangent. We assume the outputs are centered around half the supply, and we normalize the output for 5 volts full scale, or 0.1 millivolts per degree after the voltage divider. So here's the three-digit interface in operation. Now let's look at a tenth of a degree resolution. Since these inexpensive meters don't have a full 4 digits, we'll run plus or minus 180 degrees to resolve a tenth of a degree with a 3.5-digit readout. So the meter is set up in differential mode, and the voltage divider is set for 1 millivolt per degree. Here are the meter connections, just some jumpers and resistors. The input A to D's of these basic micros are only 10 bits. Of course, we could add a preamplifier, but that increases cost and complexity. The AAT's large signal, typically 1 volt peak-to-peak with a 5 volt supply, is enough for sub-degree precision without amplification. We pick up resolution by using both the sine and cosine outputs in the calculation. Also, we're averaging several sensor measurements for each angle calculation to increase the effective resolution. For the output side, this library routine takes full advantage of the microcontroller's 16-bit timer counter for a high-resolution PWM output. We also have a simple calibration routine to enhance accuracy. The routine records the range of each output. Those data are used to correct for electrical offset, as well as sensitivity differences between the two outputs. The blue LED indicates the calibration mode. We just have to turn the magnet a few revolutions. Now we're in the measurement mode, and we have precise readings with no amplification. So, we've shown how AAT sensors easily interface to popular microcontrollers with a minimum of components. Click email or call us for more information, or to order parts or demonstration kits.